I'm Donna Jones from the Vic High Class of 1957.
And I'm Charlotte Harrison Edge from the Vic High Class of 2023. It's our privilege to tell you about Ann Kipling from the Vic High Class of 1951. Ann Kipling has drawn and painted herself into the top echelons of the Canadian art world. She thinks she was born an artist on February 26, 1934. The family moved from a James Bay boarding house to the Fairfield area at 707 Moss Street in the shadows of the Victoria Art Gallery. It was certainly a quiet place, Anne recalled of her early childhood. Her father, Rudyard, was a principal in Victoria's schools. She remembers riding horses and her bicycle, occasional dinners at the old Poodle Dog Cafe at Yates and Government Streets, and lunches at the Maple Leaf Restaurant on Douglas Street. Anne began painting in her youth, and was such a good student she skipped a grade. She attended Sir James Douglas Elementary and Central Junior High before entering grade 10 at Vic High. It was natural that Anne took art classes. She fondly remembers her art teacher, Frances Cameron. She says other favorites were Stan Murphy, who taught her English and journalism, and Hazel Sargent. She admits that she planned her classes around art. Anne's high school years included a social life. She remembers going to dances at the old Crystal Gardens and at Victoria's hot spot for dancing in the 1940s, McMorran's Pavilion in Cordova Bay. She was the art director for the Camosun School Annual and attended Victoria College after graduating from Vic High.
After college, Anne began working at jobs, including with the government, which she remembers as being rather mundane and boring, and as a window dresser at Eaton's department store. In 1955, Anne enrolled at the Vancouver School of Art, and it was there that she began formulating her distinctive and expressive style. Anne believes that women were not well supported at art school. She herself was seen as a nuisance and a bit of a rebel. As a result, she did much of her coursework at home. Because of her non-conforming spirit and rebel attitude, Anne failed in her first year. However, the next year she graduated with honors, winning three major prizes, including the Emily Carr Scholarship and Canada Council Bursary. She was the first person in the history of the Vancouver School of Art to ever win those two honors the same year. The school has since been renamed the Emily Carr University of Art and Design, in honor of another Vic High alumna. Anne's art school teachers included Jan Zak, Herbert Siebner, and Rudy Kovac, who she credits for pointing her in the right direction. After art school, Anne found it difficult to get a day job. She said it was a struggle from day one, and so she eked out a living teaching art at night school. She sold her first work after graduation for the whopping sum of $25. Her works now sell through galleries for much larger sums. In the early 60s, Anne began to concentrate on drawing and developed her distinctive visual language while living in North Vancouver's Lynn Valley. Her subjects included the mountainous landscape around her, as well as people, animals, and still life. Her style has been described as a network of lines, dots, dashes, and cross-hatching as she draws her subject over time, recording their subtle shifts in movement. Her work is characterized by a flat sense of space where lines are used to frame a vibrating and gestural idea of her subject, rather than a direct representation of form. Anne's work has been compared to Chinese landscape painters and to the drawings of the Italian sculptor Alberto Giacometti. Her repeated visits to the same landscape subjects have also been likened to that of Paul Cézanne. Anne says she's fascinated by the change, movement, energy, and transformation of form in a seemingly static situation.
It was in Vancouver where she met her husband-to-be, sculptor Leonard Epp. They lived together for a time because, in the 50s, married women were not permitted to attend the art school. Seriously. Married in 1961, they lived in Richmond, Vancouver's North Shore, and in Oyama, in the Okanagan Lake Country, before ending up in Falkland, in the BC interior. They were together for 6 decades before Leonard passed away in early 2018. In 2004, Anne was awarded the O'Dayne Prize for Lifetime Achievement in the Visual Arts, and in 2008, she received an honorary doctorate from the Emily Carr University.
Ann Kipling is a unique and renowned Victoria-born artist whose works have been displayed in galleries from coast to coast, including the National Gallery of Canada and the British Museum in London. She's acclaimed for her career-long concentration on the medium of drawing and her distinctive style of mark-making. We're delighted to showcase her contributions as Ann Kipling from the class of 1951 joins the Vic High Alumni Honor Roll.